Astronomers spotted Oumuamua streaking through the inner solar system in October 2017 and quickly determined, based on its trajectory, that it's not from around here. No object from interstellar space had ever been confirmed in our solar system before. Researchers, therefore, scrambled to learn more about Oumuamua, training a variety of telescopes on the mysterious body as it barreled toward the outer solar system. No instrument was able to resolve Oumuamua, but measurements of its brightness over time indicated that it's an oddly tumbling, a needle-shaped rock perhaps six times longer than it is wide. Astronomers also noticed that Oumuamua was displaying non-gravitational acceleration, a motion not attributable to the gravitational pull of the Sun or any other solar system body. Such motion could be caused by outgassing, strongly suggesting that Oumuamua is a comet rather than an asteroid, scientists argued in a study published this summer. A different research team from the astronomy department at Harvard University recently put forward an alternative hypothesis to explain the acceleration, that Oumuamua may be a sailcraft built by an alien civilization. Oumuamua was discovered on October 19, 2017, by astronomers using the Panoramic Survey Telescope and Rapid Response System, PanSTARRS, in Hawaii. The object's name means messenger from afar in Hawaiian. Oumuamua's trajectory indicated that it's not from around here, making it the first confirmed interstellar object observed in our solar system. And Oumuamua is unique in other ways as well, in its shape, for example. Observations of Oumuamua indicate that object is extremely long and narrow, measuring perhaps 1,300 feet long by 130 feet wide or 400 by 40 meters. No other known cosmic object exhibits such a needle-like form. Nobody knows for sure what Oumuamua looks like or how big it is. Astronomers weren't able to capture a resolved image of the object, and estimates of the visitor's size are based on its brightness, and a working knowledge of the reflectivity of comets and asteroids. It's been tough to nail down what Oumuamua actually is too. Scientists initially regarded the object as a comet, but they reclassified it as an asteroid after observations failed to reveal a tail or fuzzy coma. But earlier this year, a team of researchers once again branded Oumuamua as a comet after noticing that it displays non-gravitational acceleration. That's motion that can't be attributed to the tug of the Sun, planets or other solar system objects and therefore, according to the authors of that previous study, probably resulted from cometary outgassing. That brings us to the new study, which Loeb conducted with lead author Shemuel Bialy, a postdoctoral fellow at the ITC. Bialy and Loeb don't think the comet explanation holds up because astronomers still haven't spotted a tail or coma around Oumuamua. In addition, outgassing would have altered Oumuamua's rotation period, an effect that would have been easy to identify, Loeb said. But we haven't seen such a change. There's another possible natural explanation, he added. If Oumuamua is just a fragment of a larger object, the observed motion could be from the kick that knocked that fragment loose. But such a kick would be a one-time thing, whereas Oumuamua has shown repeated non-gravitational acceleration, Loeb said. So, Bialy and Loeb came up with a new hypothesis, sunlight may be responsible. In the new study, the duo determined that solar radiation pressure could cause the observed non-gravitational movement if Oumuamua is just 0.3 to 0.9 millimeters thick. What kind of structure could be so gossamer thin? Bialy and Loeb suggested one candidate, a light sail, which is designed to harness the momentum of photons as a propulsive force. Humanity has already demonstrated this tech in space. Japan's Icarus probe successfully trekked to Venus neighborhood in 2010. NASA's NanoSail D2 and the Planetary Society's light sail craft zipped around Earth in 2011 and 2015, respectively, but their missions primarily involved proving out sail deployment. Bialy and Loeb further calculated that a light sail Oumuamua could probably survive a long interstellar trek. Given the concentration of gas and dust in the interstellar medium and the speeds at which the object would encounter these deep space flecks, the researchers determined that Oumuamua could make it at least 16,000 light-years from its home system. Whatever that may be, Oumuamua's provenance remains a mystery. This is good news for SETI, Loeb said, referring to the search for extraterrestrial intelligence. This is not speculation, he added. It's evidence-based, we have an anomaly in the data. The anomaly is that the orbit deviates from a Kepler-Orion orbit, deviates from what gravity alone would do. And the viable explanations for that do not exist, other than the one that we are proposing. Space junk or spy craft? To be clear, Bialy and Loeb aren't claiming in this study that Oumuamua is definitely an alien spacecraft. But they do think this is a real possibility. The object could be a piece of alien space junk, a defunct sailcraft that has accidentally found its way to us. or it may be an active reconnaissance craft sent here to check out our solar system, the researchers wrote in the study. What do you think? Let us know in comments.